What is up? We are outside of Walmart. We're doing our top 10 and of course our not top 10 in this video. Hope you enjoy it. I'm excited to see what they have. We've never been to this Walmart, so hopefully we find some good stuff. Gotta take advantage, gotta learn how to take advantage, dog. Stole a golf cart, I go and buy a ballpark. Drove a stolen car, now my car push start. I'm from the apartment, a crib big like Walmart. All right, definitely in our top 10, these Slim Fast Keto Fat Bombs. We have a whole video on all the Slim Fast products. Go check that out. But these are delicious, the macros are great, and the ingredients are really good. And the price, they're a lot cheaper here than we found them at Publix. Publix was $11.99. And they're only $9.97 here. The counter, these meal bars, these are actually a not top 10. They use IMO. So IMO fiber cannot be deducted like normal fiber you would. So definitely don't grab these. There's other meal bar replacements, shakes out there that don't use IMO. That looks good, right? Does that look like it'll fit me? No. Comment below and we'll show you at the end which one I pick by wearing it. And a not top 10, unfortunately, is the produce. It's cheap, but it's like really low quality. And you can, like, actually the lemons and limes look really good. So maybe lemon lime top 10, but the rest of it is, it's not great quality. And I feel like it just spoils quicker. We never get our produce from Walmart. Damn, girl, look at those muffin tops.
They used to have these mini pie things I would always get.
Would you rather go sweet corn or cranberry orange?
Out of all these, I'm probably going cinnamon coffee cake.
That wasn't the question.
Cranberry orange.
I'm going sweet corn all damn day. Yeah, that's, oh.
Check this out. If you're on a budget, this right here, 27% fat. That's 10 pounds for $20. So there's 4 times 3, 0. I can't do the math, but it's a lot of calories for very cheap. If you're on a budget, this is great. This could feed you for, what, like a week? Easy. You wanna see the kicks? Show them. Just get the whole outfit check. What do you guys think? I'm trying to increase my style a little bit. Oh, you know what I used to always get in college? Put two of these right here. Spicy chicken patties, two of these in the oven on broil in between like really cheap hamburger buns, barbecue sauce on top. That's what's up.
So this is all just not top 10. You're gonna wanna stay away from this.
I used to live on this though.
I know.
Walmart actually has some good stuff here. Like if I was buying meat here, I probably wouldn't get the beef just because in the US it's so like factory farmed, but they don't really do that with lamb. So like getting something like this, look at this. This is nice and fatty.
What is it?
Lamb breast. Maybe we'll even get this. Let's get this.
Okay.
I heard people talking about lamb breast in our comments before, and I was like, is that even a real thing? I had to Google it, and yeah, it is, and here it is. And they have like bison, ground bison. Dang, they're stepping up their game. It says fresh, never frozen, too.
That could be, they can lie about that, right?
Maybe. We never eat these, but a lot of people like them, so this is kind of a top 10, I guess. It's low-carb tortillas. One of these is 5 net carbs. It's 14 total. 9 fiber. It still has wheat if you're trying to do gluten-free. It's not the best. I mean, it's not really nutritious at all, but a lot of people love these. You can just fill them with like eggs. I used to always make breakfast tacos.
It makes it sustainable.
Bacon seems to be a thing a lot of people have questions about, so I'm just gonna grab a random one. Well, not maple, obviously, but like right here, naturally smoked hardwood bacon. Am I eating this? You're gonna turn it over, sugar. So they cure bacon in sugar. For me, personally, just because it has sugar in it doesn't really matter that much because it's such a low amount. So for 2 slices, there's not even 1 gram of carbs. So say you eat this whole pack, you're probably getting like 3 grams of sugar. It's not a big deal.
That being said, we usually just go for if there's an uncured option.
I like to look for uncured though. That's my preference.
Sausages. This is also another section we always like to look at.
See, I always look for the local ones, like right here, Georgia Boy Smoked Sausage. So I just like check the carbs. 2 carbs, kind of high for my liking personally.
What is there?
Red Hot.
What's that? That's just like a ton of food coloring, right?
Probably.
You would love this pack while you're gaming, League of Legends and just Panino in your mouth.
Yeah.
Like a cigarette. So we always find these like randomly, like in gas stations, in airports, in grocery stores, but these are really good. They're delicious and they're like a good grab and go snack, pack and a lunch. And they're pretty filling. This is 150 calories for 1 carb. That's not bad.
But you can also find some stuff like this too, like these protein packs,
yeah,
on the go. Like this is, it's turkey, bacon and cheese. So that's perfect. They have those in gas
stations
sometimes.
Olives, cheese, and pepperoni?
Oh.
Nuts, cheese, and pepperoni?
That's not olives, is it?
Oh, almonds.
Yeah, chocolate-covered almonds.
That would be a mistake.
Someone would actually like get that and they're like, I just ate all of them and I thought they were olives the whole time.
Eat the entire bag of almonds.
Sugar-free Jell-Os, pre-made. I like these. They're kind of nice for just like a sweet snack after dinner, but they typically have aspartame. Yeah, these do. These have just a million bad sweeteners and colorings and stuff. So they're not the best, but
check the other brand ones.
They're like zero calorie, zero carb. They have the same, basically. I used to just destroy this section in college. Like, I would go through this probably, this 12-pack at once while I was gaming all night. Pork rinds, Max brand. These are probably the best tasting ones in stores. And it's simple ingredients. It's fried pork skin, salt. That's it. Sometimes you'll find the pork rinds are like fried in soybean oil or something. Stay away from those. These ones are good though. Oh, they have cracklings too.
Oh, those are the best.
I like cracklings better.
We've never seen this brand.
No. Let's get one of each. Oh, and then these Bai drinks. They taste pretty good. I like them.
Caffeine.
The only thing is, yeah, I was drinking one last night and I realized it's 35 milligrams of caffeine per serving, so 70 for the bottle. So not something I'm really going to drink at night. It has 5 grams of erythritol, so this entire thing is 10 grams. Like, it's not ideal for sure. It's not something I'm going to be sipping on regularly. I consider it more of a treat, like a sweet treat type of thing.
And so these, now that I can eat tree nuts again, because I was misdiagnosed, I love these. So like, they also have like the wasabi ones, which
those
are Matt's favorites. And I was gonna grab a little container the other day, but then I looked at the ingredients and they're in canola oil. And it's like, why even put them in oil, right? They're more delicious that way. But yeah, so I said, I like decided not to get them because of the canola oil. These are my favorite, the habanero barbecue. So this is their sweetener section. They actually have a lot of great options. So they have Pure and these Splenda bottles. It looks like they have stevia packets, erythritol, and Rebiana. What's Rebiana?
That's stevia.
Oh, so these look good. But then you have these stevia in the raw. And people ask us about this. The first ingredient is dextrose. So given there's better options.
Is it?
Yeah. Given there's better options, we would just say stay away from this. So they also have these in Starbucks. And I went to grab to use one. But then I looked at the ingredients. So just, they're going to have something. This looks fancy and it's a Steve in the Raw, so it's cool. They're going to put in like Starbucks, but.
And then like this is really bad. It's sucralose and maltodextrin. So it is, it's not great. I don't know how they get away with saying no calorie. Because it has a ton of calories in it. And then things like this, like Sweet and Low, it's just chemicals. I would stay away. There's way better options.
So your top sweeteners in this section are going to be like the liquid sweeteners, so the Splenda and the Pure liquid.
Yep.
And then
these two.
The Pure packets and then the Stevia packets.
And then this section here, actually tons of good stuff. People were messaging us about this. I thought it was going to be all like really low quality. They got a bunch of good stuff. They got all these, which I like for flavoring. So like nut oils aren't the best, but if you make a dessert and you just put like a teaspoon or two of this walnut oil in there, it flavors it really good. I like grabbing this stuff. And then this right here, big surprise. Look at this, tallow and duck fat. I think we should grab some of this for sure. It's just expensive, pretty expensive.
But it's in glass jar.
Raw extra virgin cold pressed coconut and avocado oil.
In the fanciest packaging I've ever seen.
They just got a lot of good stuff.
Yeah, and then they have avocado oil. It's expensive, but it's worth it. They have coconut aminos.
Oh, we should get that.
We don't have any sesame oil either. We need sesame oil.
They have like a lot of decent looking olive oils. You want to get the dark glass jars. So if I was coming here for the first time, I would definitely grab some kind of animal fat, tallow or duck fat. Coconut oil, I'd probably go with this one right here. Glass bottle and it's organic virgin. And then some kind of either avocado or olive oil. This looks good. Nice dark glass, big bottle, pretty cheap. They even have this duck fat cooking spray. Only ingredients are duck fat and natural flavoring. I kind of want to get this even.
Just got it. What oil is in here? I can't even read it.
The best oil for your heart. Let's see what they're saying. Algae oil. It's for vegans, but also if you're cooking with algae oil, which this thing obviously makes it seem like you're supposed to be doing, it's going to oxidize really quickly. So like this product doesn't make any sense. Definite top 10. This Seasons brand. So you've probably seen in our other videos, I was like raving about Wild Planet sardines. This brand's better. It tastes better. I think the quality is about the same. These just taste a lot better, but this right here is in water. I'd like to get it in olive oil if possible. They don't have it here today though.
Rouse, you can pretty much find in most, if not all, grocery stores, but it's really cheap here, which I like. So it's a homemade marinara sauce, and they have a ton of different options. 4 total carbs for a serving, which is half a cup, so that's a lot for 4 carbs. And so it's a great option for like pizzas, for pasta, or like miracle noodles. This is absolutely a top product at Walmart. The G. Hughes sugar-free barbecue sauce, he also has a ketchup, but this is so good. I eat this like with my steak, which I know you're not supposed to eat barbecue sauce with steak, but just like burgers, just I always have this on hand. This and the ketchup, I love those. A not top 10 is dressings and mayos that just say olive oil on the front, because I can almost guarantee 100% of the time it's also going to have another oil. So sugar, extra virgin olive oil, and then canola oil and soybean oil. So they're just throwing in all the oils, but labeling it as just an olive oil dressing.
I just found this. It says MCT oils, keto coffee, mighty coffee. So it's pouches of powder. You pour it into coffee. So for one packet, it's 20 fat, 6 carbs, 3 fiber, 2 protein, a lot of ingredients. Pretty bad. I'd actually put this in the not top 10. You're just so much better off making it yourself than using all these powdered fats. Because when you powder fats, you have to add some kind of carb to stick it to, or like a fiber.
And then we always get asked about these. The Torani syrups, yeah. These syrups.
Are they sugar-free? Where are they? So the Torani sugar-free syrup, it uses acylfame potassium as the sweetener, which is like pretty bad, not a great one, but it adds a lot of flavor and people seem to like it. So if it's helping you stick to it, then I would say go for it.
They have stevia drops that are flavored that I use.
Yeah, that's what we get, the stevia drops. We'll link those below. Better stevia flavored bottles. But yeah, these aren't bad either. And in America, healthy means just the lowest calories possible. So like rice cakes, those are super healthy. We tried some of these, they're not bad. Italian style pasta bake.
Well, there's gonna be pasta in it.
No, it's 8 net carbs. Ingredients are pretty nuts, honestly. The way they make the pasta, it's soy protein, modified food starch, wheat gluten. It's like really not stuff that's good for you. But as far as this versus like, you know, lean cuisine or whatever, I would go with this probably.
So as far as dark chocolate goes, this is probably in my top, not Matt's, because Matt can go like, he's pretty hardcore. He can go 100%, too bitter for me. So I will go 92%. I haven't found like a 96. I don't know if they make anything like between 100 and 92, but I get it time to time. So one serving is 3 pieces and there's 2.5 servings in here. And that's a total of 6 net carbs. It's a good option like for on the go. And for chocolate, if you can't do the 100%. So we do this every single time we see these, because we like to reiterate that these Russell Stover candies are a not top 10. And this just goes for any like protein bars, any candy. It's always look at the ingredients.
This whole section is sugar-free actually, right here.
Yeah.
Everything here.
So I think literally everything in this section, the Werther's Originals, the Reese's, the first ingredient is maltitol. Maltitol is something you definitely want to stay away from. It impacts your blood glucose similarly to sugar, a little less, but you can't subtract those carbs. And it's a lot of maltitol. So one piece has, 9.5 grams of maltitol. In terms of gum, top gums we get, Trident or Orbit are the two we always get. So that's what we go for. But I think like the 5 gum, I think this is fine too. We used to eat that.
They make gums without the bad sweeteners, but they're all just terrible.
Yeah, so they make pure gum, which is just like the worst gum ever, but.
You get 3 chews out of it at least. Look at what I just found.
Ow, that hurt. Whoa! These are a top for sure.
Look at those.
I know.
We're just constantly coming up with new things.
I think I'd probably prefer a bowl of cereal though.
So definite top 10, especially because the price is here. So good. Real good pizzas. This is Real Good Food Company. They make all low carb, high protein stuff. So out of these here, like this is probably my, actually, I like the enchiladas a lot.
But I like the snack bites. Those are my favorite by far. I can eat those every day.
But the thing that I have lately fallen in love with that they don't have here is cauliflower pizza. So Real Good Foods cauliflower pizza, it's like higher carb, but it's made of cauliflower and it just is very substantial and filling. Like I could plow through 7 of those boxes, no problem, but like half of the cauliflower pizza really fills me up and it feels very like bready and pizza-like to me. I like it.
You can use Keto Connect for 10% off if you want to grab some.
Mega's been on a mission to find these Ben & Jerry's low-carb ice cream.
Yeah, so apparently they came out with Ben & Jerry's low-carb, and I can't find it anywhere. So if you guys know where it is, Let me know below. I've gone to like all the places that you think would have it, like grocery stores, of course, but then Target and Walmart don't have it. Speaking of ice creams, they have a lot of good options here.
Do they?
No, they don't actually, now that I'm looking.
They have Halo Top.
They have Halo Top.
Halo Top's running the ice cream shelf over here now.
So delicious. They don't have like the one we can eat, the no sugar added.
Those are my favorites. The no sugar added, so delicious.
Because they're non-dairy, but they're the blue container, so don't get mixed up.
If you want water that's like a little flavored like ice cream, Arctic Zero is right up your alley.
And that's it. So, all right, guys, that was our top products at Walmart. Let us know if we missed anything or if your Walmart has anything special, especially those low-carb Ben & Jerry's. Holla at your girl. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you soon.